Hey, welcome to The Six Inch Show, episode 107, a show that loves Star Wars, the Black Series, Hasbro, Marvel Legends, G.I. Joe, and more. This is a bit of a mini-sode, as Matt would call it. We're just going to really get straight to the point and take a look at the recent Star Wars reveals on their live stream of, what was that, Wednesday, I think?
Wednesday morning.
Wednesday morning. Yeah, so very, very recently, within the last 40 hours or probably 72 hours by the time you've seen this show, you've seen probably Matt's posts, you've seen my posts, but we're going to go in and just review, do our usual kind of a little bit more in-depth on what figures were revealed and what not. You should know who we are. You should know what this show is about. So we'll just get straight into it. Episode 106 was really not that long ago, 10 days ago or something. So there's not that many comments from you guys as yet, but some good ones. We won't dive into them just for time. Take a look at it. 106, we'd love to see your comments there, and we'll maybe pick them up on the next one. But as usual, good bunch of people. Kenneth Crilly Jr., number 107. All the usual guys are there, and girls and others. A few newbies that we've not seen in a while. Hello, Michael Kroll, and some others. But some good stuff on there. And generally, you're all a happy bunch, which is kind of cool. But let's go look at these new toys. So the live stream. Did you watch the live stream?
I did. The time zones are all going in a good way at the moment. Usually okay. It used to be 3 a.m. in the morning. And now it's 1 a.m. in the morning. So I was like, that works.
There you go. So all the I saw the reveals and I saw the pipelines and all the rest of it. And I was kind of like, do I need to watch it again? So I thought, I'll see
you whether don't you really. Do like, you, mean, like, I mean.
Patrick and or?
No Patrick, no Chris.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
What's going on? Newbies.
Maybe holidays. No, Eric.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sure.
So okay. Yeah, look, it was all good, but it was just running through the figures. There's okay. Nothing wrong with it. It's this show.
It was a format. It was
people
a format.
Talking, yeah, reading okay. off cue and delivering. So it is what it is.
I think from the figures that were revealed, I think the same old story applies. And you tell me as we go through it as well, and you guys who are watching, leave a comment, let us know. But it looks again like TVC getting all the love, TBS getting just like a little bit. But
look, I'll say on the page, on my page, there's been, and actually on Yak's page too, comments like, oh, but TVC, this is from commenters, mm-hmm. TVC had to suffer for so long, and Black Series has been such a priority. And it's like, yeah, that it's not one or the other. It's not like MCU, and let's face it, TVC and Black Series, in my mind, is the equivalent in the Marvel brand. It's not of Legends and Retro 375. It is MCU and comics lines. They're both key to Star Wars, the 375 and the six sure. inch. They can both coexist and both deliver the goods. There's no one has to suffer so the other can rise. They can
correct
succeed correct. Together, just like MCU and comic Marvel comic figures can coexist in the six-inch line in Marvel. This idea that one has to suffer and one doesn't. So if TBC had it tough for a few years whilst they disappeared and had to get their runs back, their momentum is going. That doesn't for mean sure. that Black Series has to slow down. Both of them can
should
thrive. Coexist. They should coexist. They should be both thriving. They should both be innovative. They should both be either sharing characters or going for interesting characters, and not TVC, which I'm sure we'll talk about, keep finding these new characters and new sculpts that are getting made for Vintage Collection, and we're still rolling out reuses. And it might be like, oh, but Obi-Wan's coming and there'll be Obi-Wan figures. It's like, yeah, but TVC's still filling out the gaps from the Mando that we're not getting. And it's like this whole, that's where it's not working for me. It's not one versus the other. There's clearly one team's doing something and getting it through the Lucasfilm funnel and the Hasbro funnel to get it approved, and the other team's not. But they're both delivering to the same bottom line. They're both either doing new sculpts and reuses or re-releases. But again, TVC, a low bot, Black Series, still no Lobot. It's all these things are getting through, and that's not an old Lobot, that's a new Lobot. Well, we haven't even heard rumors of a Lobot yet, and we've missed the 40th anniversary, and you know, maybe if there was ever a time for a Lobot, maybe it'd be the time when they're not doing any mainline releases, which I know we're going to go through the figures, is my major gripe of this this reveal is, once again, one new figure, which is really good, three, what do we call it, comic book figures, which is essentially reuse, which are interesting and have their ups and downs, which we'll go through. We've had one mainline wave. We're in April now.
Yeah.
Where in first really week, we've had one, and this isn't like, oh, but delays and everything else. One mainline wave revealed that we're waiting on. Revealed. And we're 4 months into the year. Usually we got a January wave. We got a May wave. And even if they're delayed, we should know what they are and when they're coming.
Yeah.
It's just bizarre.
It's we're definitely still, I think, possibly there's been a change of PR. I think there's definitely some changes coming in structure and people. Change is coming, but it's slow on the Black Series lane for sure.
But these are changes or delays that we're suffering from, as we know, a year and a half ago. So what's happening at the moment, it's a rollout.
I think given a lot of stuff that goes on, there's product. We can buy it. No, I guess you could look at it that way as well. So to play devil's advocate to what you're saying, I agree. It feels a little, it's okay.
Is there product? Compared to Marvel, Marvel's output has kept hitting and not stopped.
Yep.
This wave and that wave and the Spider-Man wave still comes in, and this wave's coming, there's going to be the X-Men wave, and the retro ones are like the archive ones, whatever it works. G.I. Joe's certainly hit a bumper, but TVC's not hitting a bumper in output of new figures and flow of figures and the number of figures. When we last stream hit... No, well, it had stopped for 5 years, but we're talking about right now in this world of there is no reason for a slowdown. You can't say, oh, but Star Wars is waiting for Obi-Wan, because the vintage collection is not waiting for Obi-Wan.
Yep.
And then you've got even the beautiful thing. Like, I mean, I love that new Lando from TVC, and that's a repaint. But it's a repaint essentially of the same figure, but it's like a new figure. And then here we are still repainting white Vaders. The Lando and TVC, the yellow shirt from Solo.
Oh, that one, for sure.
That would act in my mind for most people a new figure rather than a repaint reissue. It's changing more than...
Let's look at the figures. And then I think we'll pick up some of these points, because I think what we're doing as well is a lot of people haven't seen these figures yet. So we'll go through and we'll explain them and go through them, because they're interesting. Some we will love, some we will not love. Let me share the screen and we shall see what we can show you here. All right, let's start off first. So we've got another Gaming Greats figure. No real surprise this one, was it, I guess?
The only thing that's surprising for me is how quickly they're coming out.
That's true. They're really pop. I mean, again, but it's the same body mold, really.
I know. It's just like we're talking about the first one at the end of last year or whatever and came out this year. And then by then, fixes been announced. And then 2 weeks later, this one's announced. The next stream, will we get the fourth and final from the Delta squad?
I think, I mean, at the end of the day, people are kind of hungry to build the squad. So
I think it's great. It's just something that's never happened before. It's not like they've ever gone, oh, look, we're putting out even a Phantom Menacing, and then it's not like we got a whole completed that crew in the space of two reveals. It's quite a quick build, team building, this one.
It is indeed. And so again, just to be clear, EB Games, GameStop in the USA, now GameStop, or formerly EB Games in Canada. The UK, I think, is Star Action Figures.
Zavi
is getting, sorry, you're right, Zavi. Is he Star Action getting that? No.
I don't know.
Zavi has got this up for those of you in the UK and or most European countries.
I'll have a look at for Star Action.
Thank you very much. I Australia and New Zealand both have EB Games and Zing having this figure too. So there's quite a wide range of availability, and despite complete lack of information supplied about other countries, because apparently only the USA exists, that they are available. So why this is so hard when we're now at the, I don't know, 15th figure in this line, and you know why they can't tell us when it's available is kind of weird. But this is what you're getting. You're getting a Sev figure again, the same figure, which for me is fine as a trooper sleaze bag. I will take it, but it's getting a little, yeah, there's a lot of changes really that should have happened. He does have a more appropriate weapon, but these shoulder pads, man, it's like, what? Is Dynasty back in fashion here or something?
Well, those shoulder pads look to me like they're shoulder pads for the figure that should have been sculpted underneath them. It's kind of like, I don't know. I just look at these, and I've only played the game for a little bit, but I just look at it and just still say, I say it every time we talk about these guys, if you made an original sculpt for these guys, you could have made these four, your next squad, you could have made 20 Republic Commandos. You could have called them deluxe figures, and you could have done more with it than using this body that they've been using that just doesn't fit.
Let me
I've seen customs. If you look at, it's John Walker Customs.
Well, we'll dive to that in a second, but just there was one I shared today on Twitter, CT's custom figures. And what he's done there, which was kind of interesting, he took the shoulder pads off and put them on the side, which just looks so much better. He also did the same with the knee pads and moved them up. And it just, it really makes a difference to the figure. What is he? Yeah, he tweeted earlier on, made a few modifications to the Republic Commando boss, yada, yada, yada. And he, I presume you're seeing this. Yes. Yeah. It means the shoulder pads can also, you can get better poses as well. So yet again, it's like, you're right. It's kind of, had they maybe spent a little bit more time on this, given us a better looking figure, then yeah, just anyway, they're managing to get a lot of share out of the Bad Batch figure, because this is now going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th version of this body. So, or around that number.
Fourth, but.
And then including Bad Batch.
This is the thing. But by not doing these Republic Commandos in their own sculpt to redo them over like all the other troopers, it would be like doing the four Bad Batch figures and just giving them the same body gun. Oh, but they're all Bad Batch and they're grey.
Yeah, true.
But who's? When are you ever going to use Echo's body again from Bad Batch? Like, you know, or Tex. So, but have a look at on Instagram, John Walker Customs.
John Walker Customs, let's bring it up. Instagram. We're doing it live, people. So feel free to type along at John Walker Customs. I'm typing it right now. Here we go. And let's share on screen. There we go. So what has he done here?
Scroll down like three rows. There we go. The
this one?
Even second row or third row. Yep.
Yep.
And go to the one on the go there we go. Go down a row as well. If we go down to the there, these bulky back up. The blue kind of 501st. One up one more. No. Up one more row above the Boba Fett's.
Gotcha. Yeah.
They look like Republic Commandos.
Yeah, they do.
They're bulkier and they're bigger. You could redo them a million times over.
Yeah, you really could. Well, we're going to get to this point as well coming up shortly, because there's some other kind of, and Hasbro have got some great kind of reasons why they, why they have done them in a certain way, and I'm just not buying it. Anyway, let's get back to the figures. and quickly look at these again. Let me share. Right. So, yes, as we can see, it's quite different, and it's not got a lot of some of the features that, there's a lot of stuff missing, man. So let me just bring up a little image as well here. RC1207. Because he does have quite different shoulders. It's close, but it's not really.
It's just like you've got the wimp in the gridiron gear as opposed to the big kind of.
Look, again, I'm happy at least we're getting the damn things, because my God, it's taken so long, like 12, 15 years since the 3.75s came out. So long. So, yeah, it's, you're right, though. I mean, it's definitely the bulkiness is not there. That rifle is way, way longer in the actuality. It's just, the blasters are all tiny. Proportions are just off. It's just, they're making it from a sculpt that is not right. So we're getting a bit of a fudged bunch of commandos, but
they could have made them out of Wrecker before they make them out of this.
Yeah, but then it seems to be. I mean, that's the deluxe figure, so I think that would go.
Yeah, so can you imagine a reprint, the reissue you can do on deluxe and charging deluxe prices?
That's true. It's all strange, wasn't it? It's all very kind of weird the way they're doing this. But look, we're going to get another one anyway. We're going to get Scorch. So let's hope at least in the backpack they've got to do differently. But yeah, it's odd. But if you want to buy it, it's available to pre-order right now. It's an exclusive figure to those stores I mentioned earlier on. Pretty much EB Games, GameStop, Zing. The other one here was more of these comic book packs, which we've previously seen for Darth Maul, what was Crimson Jacks, but was actually, can't remember his name.
Yeah, that guy.
What's his name? That guy.
That guy.
The Crimson Empire comic-based boxes as such, which are really quite nice and very displayable. And look, comic fans will probably love this. I have seen these not sell too well at pretty much every online and offline source. They sell okay. But then again,
they sell good up front and then they hang around.
Yeah. But look, Vader is a core character. He's always going to be popular. Infinity's Vader, where he's redeemed and he's in white because it's the most practical color when you're going through the galaxy. For you?
Look. It was always a good moment when it happened in the comic, and I saw customs of this years ago, and it was kind of like, yeah, that's sure. Awesome. Again, the frame they've got on the inside cover is the only frame of a white redeemed Vader. So you've never seen his lightsaber, but it would make no sense to me on why Darth Vader would be redeemed and have a red lightsaber. He'd be back to blue.
I think this is an important point to make and just to remind, because I see this comic come up a lot all the time. People say, it doesn't look anything like the comic. Well, that's because Hasbro have clarified this before, and maybe did in the live stream, I don't know, but the interpretation of comic meets what they call a real world aesthetic and blends together. Therefore, they don't have to make a comic variation of it. They can reuse a existing real life quote version.
That part doesn't bother me because it is what it is. It's a white Vader.
Sure.
Even the red lightsaber doesn't bother me because we've got enough blue ones where you can do whatever you want with it. But it's just, again, this is finite exclusive. And for those who want it, that's great. As you say, it will hang around for a long time on shelves or online scenario. And there is just, in my mind, better choices of reuse you could be doing for fan channels that do not hang around and they revolve around stormtroopers. Like, you know, there's something we can talk about in this one here. And
yeah.
It'll be the Darth Maul of the wave.
It's certainly not terrible. And it's one of those ones that, it's Vader. If you want it, buy it.
Yeah.
It's not It's a repaint, pretty much like Sev. So we're two repaints in, but I think they've just passed the acceptable bar. Just from our perspective, I think, is what we're saying, generally. Another one here, Princess Leia from the more recent last 5 years or so of comics. Beautiful, gorgeous art there. And she comes in that box. And inside, we get a kind of real life interpretation of her as well. And actually looking not too bad. Is that using Padme's old...
It is.
It is, isn't it? I thought it was.
Yeah. Yet, unfortunately... and I've been sitting there with this and I've been looking and thinking about it and heard people talk about it and everything else. They're using Padme's shawl, but they don't use Padme's body. Mm. Instead, they use a Hoth body, and it just feels a little like, I mean, the Hoth body and outfit was about being in snow and cold and bulky.
Mm.
And that's not the feel of that comic. Mm. Where the other one's too sleek and everyone, sure. Look at that picture. The other picture inside, the inside cover picture.
Mm.
That's more Padme's kind of the comic is representing a more slender,
the sleek in the without a doubt, and the and also
it's white.
The shawl is white. Okay, yeah. It's brown there. Okay, touche. It's brown there, but it's white there. I think he should have went with all white. Anyway, it's certainly a good sculpt of Leia's face. I think that's reusing the Return of the Jedi version. I might be wrong, but...
Which Jedi one?
The helmeted... It looks like they've kind of stitched on the...
That's not Bosk face. Endor version.
Gotcha. Sorry, what did I say? Did I say something?
No, you said Return of the Jedi, and I went straight to...
No. Kind of looks a little like the sculpt. Maybe they've reused the face element and then glued onto a different braided hairpiece.
Yeah.
We're getting two blasters. We get some nicely sculpted boots. It certainly doesn't look like a bad figure at all. I think it.
And it looks like a new figure to me with regards to its reuse. So. Again, it's acceptable. It's interesting to get another Leia and another Carrie Fisher because
she was awesome.
Yep.
Yeah, passable. I think from my perspective, I get no for me, but for others, it may well be. And it's certainly not a bad looking figure. I think a lot of people will be really quite happy with that. And the Vader and the Sev. I think the majority will be quite okay with it. Let us know what you think, folks watching. Another new figure, or relatively new to the line, but Rogue One finally gets did come out in 3.75, a very basic version, but we never got a Saw Gerrera figure, and finally you're getting one way down the line to go with the Rogue One re-releases. Look, it looks great, but I don't know whether one for me, but what do you think? Is this one for your collection? Are you a Rogue One completist?
I think so. I mean, it completes the team. It completes the show. And in that, I think it'll probably be about 6 years before we get any of his bounty hunter kind of crew.
Sure.
If ever. Two Tubes or...
Sure.
Yep. His name was. I think this one's good. Like, I mean, I think this one's worthy. I think it's a new sculpt. It looks good. It's got all those extra little elements and details that you want. It does have some good paint, as limited as it is. Not everything has to be scratched paint and weathered paint, but it just as easily could be missing a lot of that silver and not having the details on the belt. And, you know, if it was a Gamorrean guard, that little circle on his chest would also be a different color and not silver.
Sure.
So I appreciate this. I think it's a good figure. I think it's a good sculpt. It's all brand new. It can't be reused.
Correct.
Which... again, brings me back to the Republic Commando. You make a Saw Gerrera that can only be used once, maybe twice if you gave it a different head. But it's like Republic Commandos, which you could use 20 times. We have to still use Hunter's body. So anyway, I think this is a deluxe figure. I think it's more plastic. I think there's more little features on there and more little bits of paint and everything else. I see people still complaining, saying, oh, but look how much empty space there is in the box. It's like, the box doesn't need to be filled for it to be deluxe. Zeb only had a staff or a, whatever he had. It doesn't, they're going, look at that empty space and they call that deluxe. I don't think he would fit in a standard box.
Yeah, possibly.
And if he did, he'd be very cramped like Chewbacca did in that original, not size-wise, but width-wise.
The one that they kind of crouched him down. That
yeah, they crouched him down and then they said, there is no 13 in the first box. We're going to work out how to redo the blue line and still get him standing short in the box, but we'll work it out. Exactly. So this is a deluxe figure for me. I think it, I think it's a good one, and I think people love Rogue One, and this this rounds out the kind of Rogue One crew. So for me, it probably is one, and again, it's something new, and we are lacking new.
We are very much
that
so.
That is my gripe.
I feel a little bit, just a little, the only, and it's not a complaint, just an observation and a criticism, a constructive criticism, is the hair of Sorgara. He has not got Jeb-like hair. He's quite an older guy in the movie, so yeah. There's quite a lot of gray going on. So it feels a little bit like the Han Solo Force Awakens situation where we never quite got the gray-haired Han, etc.
Yeah. Look, I think the only thing they could have added for a deluxe one is the shaved head version from the removable head. So he had the shaved head in the, in not the flashback, the flashback scene, but it wasn't a flashback because then you just jump forward. The, when he first finds Jin in the hole.
Yep.
Like if you wanted to fill that space, maybe another head, but otherwise, yeah, a little bit of weathering or a little bit of graying to that hair wouldn't go astray.
Definitely, like it's a really interesting figure. There's a lot of nooks and crannies and plugs and devices and holsters, and it does at least pay a bit of respect to the Rogue One collection by finally updating faces, bringing out a lot of the figures that, again, for those that missed them, although I don't know who possibly could have missed any of them. So yeah, again, it's not a bad figure, I think.
It lends itself to Clone Wars if they'd given it a different head. But he's a Clone Wars, Rogue One, and a Jedi Fallen character, and this is his Jedi Fallen like appearance.
There you go. There's another. You've just given them more releases, so there you go. Sorgara is available to pre-order Dirksy Toys, UTS, and lots of other good toy shops online, as well as others. This one thing really noticeable, very positive on this entire wave, was there was very few exclusives, literally two, I think, the Sev and a battle pack of Death Troopers for Hasbro Pulse. So that is noted. I noted it anyway, certainly straight away, that I just, I expected a lot of it to be exclusives, but it's not, which is good. Solid looking figure. And then we get another comic pack. They had me a Stormtrooper, but I get the point here. Sergeant Creel, though, very much like our issue that we had earlier on with the Republic Commando, is reusing the existing Stormtrooper body. And Sergeant Creel is a unit of a Stormtrooper. He is not a regular sized Stormtrooper at all. But here we go. So we're getting a regular Stormtrooper with a pauldron, which we've kind of had before for the yellow... you know what I'm talking about.
Infantry troop. Artillery.
Artillery trooper. We get what looks like a holster at the back, ammo pack, forearm pack, leg pack, and another leg pack. And some black. So, new body, pinless tech, big plus on that, but and a little backpack too. It just does not look anything like Creel. He's just
me, I just love this troopy, you know. So this is where I give it a pass, because they've done it and they've given it a little bit of difference and they've made it look a little different. Sure, he's not bulky enough, but again, this is all a one for one as opposed to the potential that could have been the Republic Commando.
Exactly. But I mean, let's dig up one of the better, clearer pictures. He's a big lad. Way, way bigger than the rest of the troopers. And as you can see there, we share that.
He's more of a Warhammer figure.
He has indeed. He's really, he's massive. Huge, big things on his shoulder. Different
shoulder pad on the different side.
Well, I think they are taking it from a different part of the comic. I think a way back, this is like unless I'm wrong, this is an early Sergeant Creel before he really becomes part of this Vader's squad where they go off. So it's kind of odd the way they're doing it, though, to then give him the... So we might get a different Creel down the line, I think. If anyone's out there who's a Creel fan, let me know. But yeah, it's not quite the Creel that... as you can see on the front of the box there as well, it's quite a different Creel from the shot in the comics. So it's a kind of early version. I think it's Luke that he battles with and he gets injured and then eventually gets bulked up, goes to the gym and gets ripped. So yeah, so he's kind of similar to this version of the comic of him. So this is, like, I guess, what it is. Formerly undercover, Agent 5241. Yeah, so we'll see. But I believe that's what it is. Although they're using some of the art from them from the later version. So I don't know, it's very confusing. But they said on the live stream, but look, I'm really happy. It's a kind of pimped out, kind of cool structure with accessories. But they could do this all day, every day, I think, to be honest. But let us know what you think, people. I'm sure this is a figure you wanted and got.
Look, this is the one. This is the one, and him and Saw are probably my two for the for the reveals. But again, I am struggling with the lack of mainline. I am struggling with we've got more gaming greats or the equal number of gaming greats this year so far than we have of mainline releases. That's like gaming greats, not even bloody comic ones. We've had more archive than anything revealed. 8. It's just these gaps are where we should have been getting Lobot, like the TDC's been getting. These gaps are where there was other opportunities, and it's just that's where I'm getting dragged down. And
I think everyone's getting dragged down. I don't think anyone's faulting them for having to reuse troopers and or other characters at times where it's applicable, it can work. But that wave is technically all pretty much...
All of them are reused except for Saw.
Except for Saw. So again, not poo-poo and Hasbro for reusing figures, that's fine, but okay, fair enough.
It's just other reuse you can do.
I know. So where we're here, just to wrap it up very quickly, because it was a mini, so it will be very quick, but to just show what the vintage collection got and compare that a little bit to the 6-inch figures, because it's interesting. It is quite interesting what they got, because frankly they're awesome. Art Trooper Jesse, looking great, loads of weapons, loads of parts and pieces, lovely card art.
We're getting removable helmets on clone figures.
I know it's depressing. I know, it really is depressing. We should just have armies coming out your ass for troopers, man. Come on.
And this is again it. Like, you've got this figure who is essentially the Echo figure with a different head and paint thing going on. So why can't we get why instead of a comic line can 6-inch not get like a clone trooper line with the fan channels?
Sure.
And you can just pump out as many as you want, and people are going to keep going on them. Yeah. And it's not going to be these
head warmers.
Yeah, it's...
Yeah. Well, unfortunately...
This is just the thing.
Hasbro are a company that has to make profit and pay employees, and they have shareholders, and, they're in love with exclusives. Although this time again,
But I'm with it. But I'm like, TVC gets... Jesse and Black Series gets White Vader. Better decisions are happening for TVC than Black Series. And it's, I don't know how it gets, who generates the list, who approves the list, how does it get through the funnel of Lucasfilm, and how does one keep getting better approvals than the other? And again, this is not TVC versus Black Series. This is Star Wars action figures.
Yeah. I just keep thinking every time we see Jesse, of our Jesse. Yes. The Force is with Jesse. Hello, Jesse.
Yes, he is.
This one was out of the blue. I knew at some point it would come, but just, again, I think seeing the classic card art, seeing the classic figure and the colours and the... it just makes me want it. And then I just think, why can't we get this 6-inch at the same time?
Well, we're getting it. So we've got a pipeline, but we get it revealed as a pipeline, and TVC is not even mentioned, and it comes out before the pipeline, and it's like, this is it. It's like,
so you know, come the on. You know, the modal nodes will follow because they will not miss an excuse to basically have the same figure but with a different weapon. Why would you? You wouldn't. You'd be insane not to do that. So understandably, but.
So I got one thing on this, because have you seen, and this brings it back to 6-inch, have you seen Yak's rumor about?
Yes, we shall. I think I actually annoyingly, stupidly shut down the page where we were because talking about looking back up.
All I can say, so it's basically saying that there will be a deluxe cantina band where it's one figure with three sets of hands and two or three different sets of instruments.
Mm.
And I'm like, that's all great, but please, let's look at this now.
Mm.
If you don't do it as a Tusken Raider, where you give what is a very simple figure in pants and a black shirt and then the head, so there's going to be reuse in there from whatever it is.
Sure.
If you don't do that as a standard figure, then... don't put out Dan as a standard figure and then give us this other one, and this is how you can build out the band with a deluxe one. Mm. Either give us a 3-pack or a 4-pack, whatever, however many members there are in the band, a 4-pack. Give us a 4-pack as a band collection, or give us 4 individual members, or give us one member with the 4 items in there. But what you're forcing people to do now is buy deluxe figures to get repetitive keyboards, repetitive instruments, and repetitive unique hands that can only be used once. So you got to fill that band out, you have to spend multiple $30 prices versus multiple $25 prices if you just release them as individual standard figures, because no one's going to go, oh, I'm going to get one, and then I'm going to get the one deluxe, and now I've got the band.
Yeah.
It's...
Yeah, as Jason at Yakface has shared, this is his rumor, which, you know, probably real. Very, very likely it's real. 3 pairs of hands, stool, band, fill, omnibox, drums, drumsticks. Yeah. The people will buy this, and they have done this before on a vintage scale where they brought out the band in a box. It was not a big seller. It's fringe shit, really, this stuff. But...
it's just weird. It's to deluxe this one when it's actually better if people want to buy multiple ones to just individually do them. Comes out cheaper, and you actually get 4 repacks as the delivery of 4 characters. Just by changing the instruments, they become 4 different characters. They're not actually repaints or ears. It's like, oh no, they're actually
exactly
original characters.
So in terms of vintage collection, there was some other stuff there very, very quickly. Lando, as we mentioned earlier on, in his Battlefront 2 outfit, or he's got a little...
Or his End of Solo. They keep calling it Battlefront
End of, 2. Yeah, like, true.
Is he Sabacc Solo?
Exactly, that's right. It is Sabacc. This was a great figure. I think it's another perfectly viable excuse to bring him back out. Probably won't sell that great. For some reason, Lando's not getting the love. But, I don't think that's a bad figure at all. Buy it or buy it not. They will know from the sales data. But it's always been a little fun figure, I think. A pretty cool one. Nice posing, nice styling. I do like it.
Oh, we're just seeing Yak's page at the moment, if you're looking at something.
My apologies. Let me just Share, share the entire screen. And there we go. Should be.
Yeah.
Yep. So you were just all I was doing was showing the Lando and the card, the final figure they had. So again, expect this in the Black Series at some point. there's no reason why they won't do it. This was a bit of an unexpected one. Not unexpected, but just nice that they finally got round to Shea Vizsla, a figure which is still one of my absolute favorites in the vintage collection. The trailer was stunning. The figure was stunning. She was stunning. Unfortunately, the facial sculpt turned out to be quite, I'll be kind if I say the word munted. It's awful. It was terrible. It just didn't look good at all. Don't know that they've made a massive improvement there, but let's face it. She's a bounty hunter. She needs her helmet on anyway, but wonderful, wonderful figure if you've never got it. And that card art alone was just drove the price of her through the roof. So again, where's the 6-inch? This is about 10 years old, 12 years old maybe. Still no 6-inch version. So one I know would have sold endlessly at huge prices. So anyway, she's absolutely stunning. Really great looking figure. Begging to be done in 6-inch. Maybe they've got it around the corner, hopefully. It looks a little better to see the facial sculpt there. It still doesn't really look like her, but there you go. We're at least getting a new head sculpt because it would have been criminal to redo that old one. And maybe it was just a bad, bad thing. But there we go. Great looking figure. Very poseable. And flame effects. Fabulous. Another one there was the Death Trooper 4-pack, kind of following on from the Stormtrooper 4-pack. Pulse exclusive, so that is UK, Germany now, which has Pulse, and the US. You should get a chance to buy these, formerly kind of Walmart, this one, this is the 3.75-inch version, and other troopers altogether. Not one of them comes with the rifles, I think, by the looks of it. Oh, they do. There you go. Like, why they don't come with the rifles? So yes, want to army build your Death Troopers? You can. Again, something that I don't know whether this would. I think Hasbro are terrified this would not sell in the 6-inch line, but I kind of think it would.
I don't know whether these ones would, but the other ones would have. Everyone's had their opportunity to get these and do these and whatever in 6-inch, and it's still the Stormtroopers, the Rebel Troopers, the.
Yeah, troopers. Another great looking figure here was the Clone Wars Mandalorian Death Watch Airborne Trooper. Nicely kind of photo montaged and kind of tweaked from the animation and made into real life style. So it's reusing the recent Return of the Jedi Boba molds or parts thereof, which is kind of interesting, and a rifle this time. And it's just like, why am I not getting 6-inch? Why? We kind of got one of these, but it was a bit of a fudge. Never mind. So great looking trooper, nonetheless, with that rifle. And we did get this in 6-inch, but again, it was a bit of a fudge. But the Super Commando Captain is here, or the Maul Trooper. I don't know why they didn't just put the art from the show, but hey-ho. It is what it is with these crony thorns. It's a good-looking figure, but yeah. Again, it's just going to sell. Regardless, it's Mandalorian, it's going to sell. And it's another pick of Saw Gerrera. And that was it. Apart from a couple of reveals, as we mentioned. Yakface shared these out. Pipeline reveals. This was confusing. Grogu in his pram. Now, this is the shot from the boat where he gets the capsule kind of goes underwater.
Yeah.
So maybe it's a damaged caught Grogu. I don't know. With a squid or something. I don't know.
How's this a pipeline reveal, honestly? It's just Grogu comes with every second Mando figure these days, and then we've got him as the individual one. If this is a little box thing, that's going to be a little bit of bigger box for it's a Christmas decoration. I'm sorry, but it's a Hallmark Christmas decoration. And it's what can we get out of this kind of thing. And this is a pipeline. This is the one we're meant to be looking forward to as a standalone release.
It's just,
well, they've got it. One thing, it will sell. That's what this is about. It's about what will sell.
Yeah.
I know. I hear you, but it's what will sell. Migs Mayfield again, season one kind of update. So yeah, reusing the head and putting on a new bounty hunter, kind of relatively plain body he had, but it's okay. Not terrible. There was another couple just for that were quite interesting from the Vintage Collection line. They're getting the Dark Trooper. Well, 6-inch got one. Luke Mandalorian, we've got one. Artillery Stormtrooper, we've got one.
Do we?
What?
We don't have a Luke Mandalorian. One's meant to be coming for Return of the Jedi. So whether it's got, we're going to once again not going to get the black glove one.
I thought they revealed this on a pipeline.
No, it was meant to be with the Rancor. Remember?
Oh, is that what it was? Okay.
Yeah, so it will come for Return of the Jedi 1983, but this is Mandalorian Luke, which will have its differences.
Given the amount of time that we've seen Luke in the Mandalorian series, I mean, they would be off the meds to not have one for the Black series. It would just be insane to not have one, I would think so.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that is absolutely happening and getting me in the works. Although this one got me the Clatoonian Raider. What? Really? It's just so niche for the Vintage Collection, but I guess maybe they can reuse.
This is my thing. This is a brand new sculpt, new character from Mandalorian, which is a fringe character that's coming to TVC, and we're still getting White Vaders and Archives.
I mean, we don't know. I mean, the body could easily probably reuse.
The body could be reused for the Return of the Jedi Jabba's gang.
Sure. So,
but again, my point being, this is new sculpt, or just
for some of them, definitely.
It's a new head, and here we have all these things like we can't get an Obi-Wan archive because that's a new head, and I'm just like, it's just messed up. It's just so sick at the moment in my mind.
I think this is
being said from love. It's not being said from
No, I agree.
I hate The Last Jedi and Kathleen Kennedy. It's not the equivalent of this. Sure. It's just a frustration with how stagnant it is.
I think if, from my perspective as well, when you analyze the line, you take a kind of bird's eye view of it. You've got deluxe figures in odd shaped boxes. You've got regular mainline stuff. You've got exclusives in those boxes. You've now got the what seems to be coming the norm, the comic kind of Velcro padded box stuff that's going on. Are we getting any more 40th 6-inch figures? I mean, we get the odd random one now with Power of the Force. We've had three figures in the 6-inch line, which were from reproductions of the first 12 figures of Star Wars ever. But we're kind of like, it's a bit of a dog's breakfast. And then when you go back to the beginning of the line, black and orange, excellent figures, kind of like Super 7 Ultimates. The definitive figures of each character, no messing, all the gear. And then we're just getting Christmas figures, carbonized figures.
And my thing is, and this is why I'm painting over mainline figures.
Mm.
The mainline figures are excellent.
Mm. Some of them are
the stunning. Jedi Stormtrooper, that recent wave that had come out at the end of last year was Bib Fortuna and all this stuff. They're awesome figures. And then you get the next line, which is going to be Death Watch with Ahsoka with another killer thing. It's like, my point isn't that the mainline figures are so strong and so good and everything that is good about Black Series.
Mm.
But we are doing, for every mainline figure now, it's like we've got 15 or 16, with the greatest respect, junk revolving around them. And that's not junk in a bad way, but what it is, it's not core quality Bib Fortuna new sculpts. And I get that we need to be focused on reuse and whatever at times. I still think it could be doing get done better. But the fact is that Star Wars Black Series for the first 6 years did not rely on reuse, and it's quite correct. Clear there is a decision that is saying more Marvel, more G.I. Joe. It's like, these figures don't lend themselves to it. And if they do lend themselves to it, they're called clone troopers, which people are happy to buy. Why are you focusing on white Vaders? Why are you focusing on Princess Leias that come from recent comics and whatever else, when you've got Jessies and you've got a million other clone troopers that people are ready to buy and do stuff with? And it's, that's where I'm coming from. You've got a stormtrooper for George Lucas, which I know you've reviewed and everything, with a removable helmet. And here we are doing White Vader and friggin' even Creel or whatever, when there could be a Han and Luke with removable helmets. Classic, feeds the thing, gives the new bodies, updated heads.
Totally.
It'll be a killer. And it's just...
You're right. I mean, way back, the black and orange line was, everything was new, stand out, and they still look absolutely classic. Hell, we're still using only until recently, the Boba Fett sculpt. Some 2013, so what's that, 7, 8, 9 years ago, nearly 10 years ago.
We still used him last year.
I know.
The for a figure that's coming this year.
Exactly. The Stormtrooper was used not all that long ago for a Chrome version, which is still it, if so.
So, I guess, how do I say this one? No, I won't even say it because I've lost it. But it's just, you know. Oh, this is what I was going to say. Let's just say, for example, and I'm taking a guess, it costs $50,000 to make the...
sculpt.
The metal sculpt or whatever it is that they make the figures off. You're spending $50,000 on the Saw Gerrera, or even the Saw Gerrera's the finest deluxe, whatever, but I'm just trying to think of a unique one that's a bit ho-hum. I should have prepped
in the Rogue One line?
No, just in any line of what's been going on. Look, it doesn't matter. Then $50,000, if you're going to be making your money back on them, and it's all about reuse because of those sculpts and everything else, again, spend $100,000 to make two trooper molds of the same mold and just pump them out. And just, I don't know. Like Rebel Troopers, Hoth Troopers, Endor Troopers, which could be coming next year or whatever it is.
Yeah.
There's so many. The Ewoks would be better than some of these bloody Infinity ones. And yes, we might be getting Wicket next year or something, but let's go with Logray and Chief Chirper and even random Ewoks to make a collection of them on shelf.
I think to be fair though, I think one criticism that or one point to stand up for the Hasbro team in some way is I look at some of the comments and the poison.
I don't read comments, to be honest.
Oh, well, it's interesting. I see them on some of the live streams as well, some of the kind of, as the chat's kind of going on. They kind of can't win sometimes as well, because no matter whether where you and I would probably say, you know, for goodness sake, make more troopers, they get a bunch of people who come up with, God almighty, the most obscure character, like the cleaner in the background at one point in the Phantom Menace that was sweeping the floor. What? They want to figure. So there's a real, they can't win sometimes, but trooper still.
It just feels like they're not going to win by doing what they're doing at the moment, because
it needs refocused.
Like, I can't stress how much I don't read streams and all that, because to me that's like reading a live review of The Last Jedi. So when I read just the community around my page, it's just like the number of people I know have had such passion for this line, such incredibly talented toy photographers.
For sure.
And just people who are so massively, even though they weren't great toy photographers, they were a part of this community. They were commenting on everyone's pages. They were loving everything, this and that. All I see them now is bagging the shit out of it. And not for the fact that it's this or that. It's like, I I just have no interest in it anymore. Mm-hmm. And I still love Star Wars, but Black Series is dead for me. And I'm just like, they're going, oh man, at some point, there's going to be a tectonic shift, and it's rumbling. And I don't want to be a voice of negativity, because I don't think it's not like, again, I always come back to it, it's not Last Jedi hate, it's actual frustration for the fact that you have these options on the table
and they're not taking them,
or you're giving them to the hardest people to make them accessible, or just everything is just so ass backwards. And you know,
it's not that it's in my mind, it's just utterly terrible and it's in the ditch. It's just
because Mainline's awesome.
Yes,
I mean, it's just none of them.
Great,
it's just none of them.
Mm. There's a lot more misses than there are hits, and it's just regardless of what they would say, there's an awful heavy amount of reuse in the Black Series line compared to TVC, or it feels that way anyway, and that perception needs to change, I think. But to vary it up and shake it up.
Also, my tip to them would be, they can't not do this, but I was about to say, if you've got nothing exciting to do, don't just push a stream out, but they've got to push the pre-orders out. But it's the problem is like for the last year, there's been very little excitement aside from the two mainline reveals for any of the streams, which just means, you know,
It's treading water. Yeah. Well,
Marvel's not suffering from that. Marvel is not suffering from that.
For sure.
G.I. Joe's not suffering from that. I don't know about Power Rangers. But Star Wars is kind of like, what are we going to? Yeah. And I know Celebration will be.
And Kenobi.
Obi-Wan. And it will be whatever. And we'll get this little boost, but then it will still be. There's a little bit of Kenobi, like Obi-Wan, but we're still not getting this or this Inquisitor, because that'll be in a year's time after because we didn't get to see the trailer until the same time as all of you. And it's just going to be like, right, so what's coming from Mando season 2 then? Oh, nothing, because we're focused apparently on Kenobi, and it's just going to be messy. I don't know.
It'll be like this for a while, until we kind of hopefully... Look, the fact the... the press releases that came out from Rogers and Cowan, I thought were straight to the point. They gave all the images. Just the way they present it was much easier for me to work with, I thought.
A Dropbox, starters.
It's just one and one big thing. And it just, I love the way
Lawrence. And the press release is not a PDF.
Yeah, just, yeah. He knows great. What he's doing, Lawrence and Julia, I think it is. So, yes, good on that front. So let's hope more changes come. But not a terrible bunch of figures, but I kind of, a bunch of figures, I think, is the best way to sum up. A bit of semi-scale, feeling my Moon Knight scales there. Let us know what you think of all these figures, TVC or TBS. Let us know. We're trying to bring in the love of all of you so you can see all these, because they're all toys, as Matt says. So any final thoughts, anything else to add? I don't think we can we? That was the live stream, and it's a wrap. We shall see you for episode 108 for a more normal episode. And until then, see ya.